Hi, Steve Kafka again. I'm doing demonstrations on my larger size scroll brushes. This is a 5. I've already done the 6. And I'm using a gold panel. We don't have these for sale because you can't make a mistake. If you make a mistake, you throw it away. You can't clean this or anything, so we don't offer it to the public. I have a large supply, so I'm going to be striping on a lot of them because they're fun. This and silver. I mixed already in one of my cups some black with a little bit of smooth stroke in it. I'm going to do that as the first color. Then I'm going to mix. I don't buy all the colors. I mix my own. This is emerald green and processed blue, and I'm going to mix them together to get a really nice turquoise. And then I'm going to do a color fade with white and fade it out on top of the black. So without further ado, there's a lot of you buying my zeros and ones, and that's great because I love them. But I want to show you what these are capable of. And these are capable of some very fine stuff, which people don't really understand that. But let me show you how I like to use them. First, I'm going to lay out the grid, which we always do. I do a demo on the grid because I think it's a wonderful tool, especially if you want to learn symmetry. Do all your verticals, and then flip it over and line up the holes, and you do your horizontals. Get a perfect 1-inch grid. You can make this any size you want, too. Any job. I use an omnichrome pencil because they don't melt. They're not gooey. I always dust the surface too. I'm going to start out with the black and do a center line. And they're speeding up the palette. I don't move the brush this quickly, but I'm just speeding it up for. I don't want to spend all my time doing this. I just want to show you how I set the brush tip down. And get on the tip, do my first vertical, right next to it. This is the 5. Very, very fun brush. I could do these all day long. They're just so much fun. And so could you. Do some loops, push, pull, keep the brush moving, push, up, double loop out, triple loop. Just duplicate that on the other side. Push. Pull. Be cognizant of where you were on the other side. And, try and hit your marks. Push. And then do a triple loop out. You can see the amazing amount of paint that this brush does hold. So now I've got a basis for a design to add color. I have to let this sit for just a little bit, enough for me to mix my paint. I'm going to wipe the paint out of the brush with a paper towel. That way I don't contaminate my thinners. Here's the emerald green and some processed blue. It's about a 50-50 mix. Always a little smooth stroke. I'm going to warn you that this becomes very addictive to use smooth stroke. It just makes everything nicer. You have the inherent problems with contamination, topping colors. Stirred up real well with there's popsicle sticks. Get a first color. With this, I'm going to put the white down on the palette. Again, just a drop of smooth stroke in there. Or two. Give it a stir. We sell these paint bottles too. So first I'm going to palette with the base color teal. And
get some of this in there, and then I'm going to start the fade out. I'm going to mix right on the palate. It's a shame this gold, well, we can't sell it. If you make any mistake, you cannot fix it without destroying the gold. What a shame. We already purchased a bunch of it before we found this out. I assumed that it was good. It wasn't. So I sell a lot of candles with this gold and the silver. And it's available. I mean, if you want it, you understand the risk. Let's go first. Gotta try this brush though. It's an amazing brush. It's obviously right between the 3 and the 6, so that's how it performs. It's like a bigger 3. And I've got the proper amount of weight. Start the fade. Add a little bit of white. Mix right on the palette. Here's the first. This is the third color. You start out with black, it makes it a little bit more dramatic. Because if you just use the color, white. Each time you add white, obviously it gets the next hue. It's the next color in the gradient. See now how this is starting to fade. Put some dots in. And the two-handed method allows you real precision when you point the tip down. More white. I'll up to a very light teal. Just move it over a little bit so you're not getting it the same as the previous color. Bring something right down the center, right up the center. I'm going to be using the 5 a lot more. I just thoroughly enjoyed using this brush. It holds a lot of paint. Wrap around thing. This kind of like bundles everything together for me. That's my way of thinking when I do this. It wraps it up. This one here, you always look at where you're going. Four times there. That's it. My signature in here. Again, I use the tip of the brush. And I sign on these panels, I sign them a little bit bigger than I do on a vehicle. Usually I cover my signature with a diagram. I put my name and a date. There's the finished piece.